Hi, welcome to Theory of Computation. In this video, let's discuss about languages. All the machines that we are going to discuss in this course, like finite state machine or pushdown automata or even Turing machine, is going to compute the membership function of a set. And that set is not any arbitrary set, but instead it is formal languages. So let's try and understand what these formal languages are, or simply what a language is, how the members will be, what are the operations that we can do with these languages, all those things in this video. A language is a set of strings. And what is a string? A string is a sequence of symbols. Let's take an example. Let's consider an alphabet sigma, which are English alphabets, small a to Z, and we can choose these symbols and arrange them in some sequence to form the string. Say for example, take the word CAT. We have chosen C, the symbol C, followed by the symbol A and then T. And we have similarly chosen three different symbols to form the string dog and house, etc. If you observe the length of the string, it is not necessary that we have to limit with 3 or 5 as in the case of house. The length can be arbitrarily long, but it has to be finite. That is, the length has to be a countable number. And it's not necessary that the symbols that we choose for a particular string has to be distinct. We can choose the symbols repeatedly. Say for example, if I form a string APPLE, then the P will be repeating. That is also possible. So when we form a string, we have to choose the symbols from the alphabet and we have to sequence them in a particular order, and the length of the string has to be finite and the symbols can repeat in the string. Let us consider a small alphabet sigma with only two members, A and B. Now, a single symbol from alphabet is a string with length 1, and then we can form a string of length 2, which is AB. I can form it like AA also, and this is a string with length 4. It's not necessary that I have to always start with the first symbol. I can choose any symbol, okay? So this is B followed by A and so on. And this is a string which is really long. And sometimes we will use variables to represent some string. Here AB is a string from this alphabet sigma. But we usually denote the string with a variable like U, V, W, and we choose the name of the variables in such a way that they do not lie in the symbol set, so that we don't confuse with what is the symbols in the alphabet and the variable name. So here we have chosen U to represent the string AB and V to represent another string BB, B followed by triple A and so on. Now let's discuss about the string operations. The first operation that we are going to see is the concatenation. Now let's consider two strings, W and V. W has A1, A2, etc. up to AN, N symbols, and V has B1, B2, etc. up to BM. The length of W need not be equal to length of V, that is N need not be equal to M, and any of the AIs can be repeating, similarly BIs can also repeat, and both the strings need not be from the same language as well. Now when we concatenate W with V, we get WV string, which is the W string, which is A1, A2, A3, etc. up to AN, followed by the string B, which is B1, B2, etc. up to BM. Consider W to be ABBA and B to be triple B followed by triple A. Now the concatenation of WV will be, we have to write the string W. So we have ABBA which is W followed by V which is triple B followed by triple A. Next is the string reverse operation. So consider a string W with A1, A2, etc. up to AN, N elements. Now string reverse W, in the power we write it as R but we read it as WR, which is string reverse. Yes, we have to write the string from right to left. So we get AN, AN minus 2, etc. up to A2, A1 in the reverse order. Consider an example. W is A, B, A, B, A, B, B, B. Now when you wanted to reverse the string, we have to start from the right and move towards the left. So we have triple B followed by triple B followed by triple A, then B, A, B, A. So that's the string reverse operation. Next is string length. Given a string W, A1, A2, etc. up to AN, the length of the string W, we denote it by the modulus operator, is the number of symbols in the string. So we have N symbols here, so the length of W is N. For example, consider the string ABBA. Since there are 4 symbols here, the length of the string is 4. Now here only 2 symbols. Although they are same symbols that are repeating, we will count this as 2 different symbols. So this is 1, this is 2. Okay, the length of the string is 2. And here even if you have a single symbol from the alphabet, this is considered as a string and the length of the string is 1. Now let's consider the recursive definition of the length of the string. Consider a symbol A which belongs to this alphabet sigma. Now the basis of the definition is this one. For any symbol A that belongs to sigma, the length of the symbol is 1. This is the basis. Now the inductive definition is, if W is a string and A is a symbol, then WA concatenated together is a string. So the inductive definition says the length of WA is equal to length of W plus 1. Now let's consider an example. The string ABBA. Now consider this ABBA as W and the symbol A. So W is ABB and A is the symbol. So you have length of ABB plus 1 by the inductive definition. Now AB will be considered as W and for this B we will have plus 1 and this plus 1 will come here. And this, for this one, A will be considered as W and for this B we have 1 and for these two ones we have two ones here. Now this is the basis of the length of the definition. So the length of A is 1, remaining 3 plus 1s comes from the previous step. So totally we will have 4. What will be the length of strings that are concatenated? Suppose if U and V are two different strings, then UV is a concatenated string. Now what is the length of UV then? It is the length of U plus the length of V. For example, suppose if you consider U as the string ABB, AAB, the length of U is 3. Because we have 3 symbols here and V is AB, AAB, so the number of symbols here is 5. The concatenated string UV is AAB followed by AB, AAB, which is this string, And if you count the number of symbols here, that will be 8, but we need not actually count it because we know that you had 3 symbols and we had 5 symbols. We can just add them up to get the length of the concatenated string. The empty string or the null string is a string with no symbols. And we represent the empty string or the null string with epsilon. And remember that this epsilon is not a member of sigma. That is, it does not belong to sigma. Null string does not belong to the alphabet sigma. But this is a special symbol that we use to represent an empty string or a null string. And it is worth to note that the length of empty string is 0 because we do not have any symbol from the alphabet. And when we concatenate the empty string with any string W, either in the left or in the right, then we get the same string. Because when we concatenate a null string with W, since there are no symbols in epsilon, we will get W only, whether we concatenate in the left side or in the right side. For example, epsilon concatenated with ABBA is simply ABBA. And if you concatenate epsilon in the right position also, you will get the same W. Substring is a subsequence of consecutive symbols from a string. For example, consider the string ABBAB. Now, AB is a substring. Similarly, ABBA is a substring. We can consider even a single symbol from the string and consider that as a substring. And here it is BBAB is a substring. But remember that it has to be consecutive symbols from the string. I cannot take A followed by AB, like AAB. I cannot write AAB leaving out this BB because that is not a valid substring because it is not consecutive. And the entire string, I can say ABBAB is a substring of ABBAB itself. That is also possible. Now, what is prefix and suffix of a string? Prefix is something that is before the string that we are considering, and suffix is what is following the string. Now consider the string ABBAB. Now if you consider the entire string, what is before this string? It is a null string. We do not have anything here. So it is null string. The prefix of the entire string is the null string. If you consider BBAB as a string, then what is the prefix? We have A as the prefix. And similarly, if you consider A as the string, now BBAB is the suffix of A. Similarly, we have AB as the prefix of BAB, that is what is given here. Similarly, BAB is the suffix of AB, and so on. Similarly, when you consider the entire string, what is following the string? It is empty string again. So when you consider ABBAB as the prefix, then what is following the in the suffix of this, we have only the empty string. In general, if you have a string W, which is considered as UV, we are splitting the string W as some U and V, then U is the prefix of V and V is the suffix of U. And V and U can be empty strings as well. If you consider U to be W, then in that case V will be epsilon. Otherwise, if you consider V to be W, then U will be epsilon. The next operation is repetition or repeated concatenation. When we have a string W, when we represent W power N, we wanted to repeat W for N times. That is, I wanted to concatenate W with W and this with another W and so on up to N W's. For example, consider ABBA, which is a string, and I wanted to concatenate it twice. That is, I want to have ABBA followed by another ABBA. So this is W square, and a special case is W power 0. That is, I don't want to repeat W. That means that I don't want to have anything. That means that it is the null string. So for any W without repetition, power 0 will be the null string. The star operation, usually we don't call this a star, we call this as a closure, clean closure actually. And what is sigma star? Sigma is alphabet and sigma star is the set of all possible finite strings from the alphabet sigma. For example, if sigma is A comma B, then sigma star will include all possible finite strings which are made up of this A and B's. So null string is string with length 0, and this is one time we get the symbols. So we call this as strings of length 1 because we have just the symbols as strings. And then we will have strings of length 2, then we have AA, AB, BA, BB, and then we have strings of length 3, then followed by length 4 and so on. This is an infinite set. This is positive closure operation. It means that sigma plus, which is the positive closure of sigma, a set of all possible finite strings again from sigma except the null string. We remove the null string from sigma star and everything else will be available in sigma plus. Consider the sigma to be AB. So sigma star will have null string AB, AA, AB, length of strings of length 2, strings of length 3, etc. So sigma plus, the positive closure, will have all the elements from sigma star except this epsilon. So we'll have A, B, strings of length 2, strings of length 3, strings of length 4, etc. What is a language? A language is any subset of sigma star. That is a language. For example, sigma is A, B, then sigma star will have strings of length 0, length 1, length 2, length 3, etc. And we can have any subset of this set and call that as a language. Now this is set of null string. So this is a language with only one member and that member is a null string. Here we have a language with three strings. Here we have six strings. All these languages are finite because we are able to list down the elements and the number of elements are countable. So it is a finite set. So it is a finite language as well. But usually when we consider a language in this course, we will have some special property a language will satisfy. We will not arbitrarily choose any subset of this and call that as a language. But even this is a language, that's not a problem. But the languages that we will consider in this course will have some properties. Consider another language L from the same alphabet AB. Now L is defined as set of all strings of this form A power N, B power N, such that N is greater than or equal to 0. Now what does it say? The number of A's should be equal to the number of B's. So we have, when N is equal to 0, we have no A's, A power 0 and B power 0, and we know that any string with no repetition represent a null string. So a null string concatenated with null string will yield another null string. So we have the epsilon, that is a member of L. And when N is equal to 1, we have A power 1, B power 1. So we have AB. When n is equal to 2, we have AA followed by BB. When n is equal to 5, we have the string, and so on. So this n is arbitrarily long, and we can have any string with a power n, b power n, and that n is countable. Remember that n can be any large, like I can say n is 1000 or it is 1 million, but still it is countable. Consider this string which is ABB. This is not a member of L. Why? Because the number of A's and number of B's doesn't match. Number of A's is 1 and number of B's is 2. So this is not a member of the language. What are the operations that we can perform on languages? Since languages are sets, subsets of sigma star, subset is also a set. So any usual operation that we do with sets, we can perform with languages as well. For example, consider this as L1, language L1, and this is L2. Now L1 union L2 is A we have here, AB we have here, and then we have AAA, 4 A's that we have here, and then we have BB that we have here, and then AB is already there in the union, so we need not repeat. So remember that this is a set, so we need not repeat the elements. And should we write it in this order? Like, should I not write the L1 completely and then the elements of L2, like A, AB, AAA, then followed by BB? That is also possible, but only thing is that we have written here in the order of increasing length of the strings, that's all. But writing BB after this 4 A's is also fine, that no issues. An intersection whichever is common among the two sets we get as the result. Now here AB is available in both the sets, and the intersection will be AB. And set difference, L1 difference L2. So in this case I have to list out all the elements of L1 and remove whichever is available in L2. So here AB is there, so I have to remove AB. So rest of the elements A, AAA will be the result of the difference. And what is complement? Given a language L, we know that L is a subset of sigma star. So L complement will be sigma star difference L. That is the complement operation. And suppose consider a language L with two strings A, AB, and we wanted to find the complement of this. And we know that a sigma star made from A and B will be a sigma, which is the epsilon, which is the empty string, and then we will have A. Since we wanted to find the difference, we will not have this A. Then the single element string, which is B, and then A we will not include because it is available in L. And length of string 2, we have 4 combination. Out of that, we will not include BA. Rest of the 3 we have included. And then all the strings with length 3, with length 4, everything will be available in the L complement. How do we perform reverse operation with language? L power R, LR, which is nothing but set of all strings of the form W reverse, such that W belongs to L. If W belongs to L, then I have to reverse every W in the L to get L reverse. For example, consider the language AB, AAB, BABA. Then when we want to find the reverse of this language, I have to write the independent strings in the reverse order. So AB will appear as BA, AAB will appear as BAA, BABA will appear as ABAB. Consider another example from the same alphabet AB. Now L is of the form A power N, B power N, such that N is greater than or equal to 0. Now what will be L reverse? We have to just reverse it, right? So we will have B power N, A power N, such that n is greater than or equal to 0. Given two languages L1 and L2, L1, L2 will represent the concatenation of the languages L1, L2. And the members of the language will be XY such that X belongs to L1 and Y belongs to L2. Consider an example. L1 is a set with 3 strings and L2 is a language with 2 strings. Now, the concatenation of L1, L2 will be A will be from L1, B will be from L2, and A is from L1 and AA is from L2. Similarly, we have AB from L1, B from L2, AB from L1, AA from L2. Then we have BA from L1, B from L2. Then BA from L1, AA from L2. So we have these strings AB, AAA, ABB, BAB, AA, BAB, BAAA. So this is the concatenation of two languages. This is concatenation performed n times. That is repetition, L power n. We wanted to concatenate L n times. So take for example A comma B, which is sigma, and we want to have power 3. We want to concatenate this for 3 times. So we will have, this is L, so L concatenated to L, again concatenated to L. So we will have this A in the beginning. So this is actually L1, like same L, but we can represent it like L1, L2, L3. And each of the element will be coming from every set. So this is from L1, this is from L2, this is from L3. This is L1, L2, L3. L1, L2, L3, and so on. We have to write all the possible combinations that we can get from these 6 elements. And as a special case, we have L power 0. That is no repetition of L. That means that it is set of empty string or the null string. So this is true for any language. Take any language and say if it is 0 repetition, the result is the set of null string. Consider one more example. Now L is A power N, B power N such that N is greater than or equal to 0. Now we wanted to find L square. That is, I wanted to concatenate L with N, L. So it has to be A power N, B power N, again followed by A power N, B power N. But this N need not be the same. See, as long as we are ensuring the number of A's followed by the number of B's are same, it is enough. That is the representation of A power N, B power N. And this N can take any value. So when we concatenate, we need not give the same index of this N here, or the power N here. So N and M can be different, but A's and B's we have to match. Here if you put M, then B should also be raised to the power M. And if you are concatenating 3 times, then we will have some A power, say L, and B power L, and so on. So here in the first case we have considered N is equal to 2, so we have AA followed by BB. In the second case, M we have considered as 3. So 3 A's followed by 3 B's. This is a member of L square. So it's not necessary that N has to be equal to M. This is clean closure operation we represent using the star. So L star is L0 union L1 union L2, etc. This is null string. This is same as L. Whatever the members of L that we just make union with the null string. Then we concatenate L with L and so on. Consider an example. The language L is ABB. So these are the two strings in L. Now its clean closure is the null string, which is L power 0 union. So we'll have the elements added, which is L. So I have the members A, B, B, then L square. L concatenated with L. So A concatenated to A concatenated to AB, then BB concatenated to A, then BB concatenated to BB. So this is actually L square, this is L cube, and this is an infinite set. L cube, then L power 4, all the sets we make a union of them. Positive closure, we just eliminate the null string from the clean closure set. So we will not have L power 0. We'll have L power 1 union L power 2 union L cube union L power 4, etc. So we have, if you consider the set A, B, B, which is the language, and you want to compute the positive closure, we will have L, which is A, B, B, then we will have L squared, then we have L cube, L power 4, members of all those sets. We'll make a union and get the positive closure. These are the operations that we can perform with strings, which are the members of the language and the language itself. And all these slides I have taken from the Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute. In the next lecture, we will learn how to construct the finite state machine. Thank you for watching the video.